Hi everyone, welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch video course. We're almost done, we're starting part 6 now of this course, Local Export. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So as you can see, we are in the final part, deployment, and we're going to look at two different deployment options, and this video is going to cover the local deployment option. So let's go ahead and look at what this does for us. As you know, we're using Global Music Supply as a fictional case study to guide us through this. And we set up all the applications, everything's functional. We set up security, we set up logging, everything is good and ready to go. Now we just need to let our users move into the new system and make it live. But before we can do that, we need to move it to a live environment or a production environment. That way, users have this static environment that isn't going to change while you are making new features available in the development versions, or while you're developing those, they won't see any errors or any new features that aren't ready to go. So you can keep developing and they can have access to a static, stable version. You might do this on a separate production server at one point, but for now, you're going to keep it on the same server and do a local deployment. In the next video, we'll look at how to do an FTP deployment. So let's go ahead and go over the script case and deploy our project. Okay, so here we are in our project in the development environment, and this is very easy. We need to go up to the project menu and choose deploy applications right here. So click on that, and we have the option to deploy all the applications or select applications. We're going to do all of them this time. Click next on that. We're going to do typical here. We can do some advanced settings if we want, and then we want the common libraries and CSS and everything with it. We're going to be deploying to a 64-bit Linux environment. Choose whichever environment you want, and then the initial application, which is going to be your login application. This is the first application that loads when the users come to your website. You can generate a zip file or a tar.gz. We're going to deploy to a server directory, so I have the path to that right there. So this is a directory I set up for the live environment. You can put that wherever you want on your server that's accessible. Wait for it to deploy. This will take just a second to deploy all of our applications. And it'll display a loading bar here, and then here it is ready to go. And as you can see, it deployed all of our applications okay. There's no errors or anything to that folder. So now we can go over to that place, and as you can see here, there's an error message because we haven't set up our connections. So here's the admin environment for the production environment. It's going to ask us to change that once we log in. So there's our new password. So set that to something secure. This production environment admin console will be very useful to you as you manage the production environment. So you first need to set up the connection to the database. So you can have a separate production database, which could be very useful to you. So choose your settings for that, just like we did when we created our project and set up our database, and enter in the credentials for the correct database that you want. Make sure you enter in the correct password. And then you can go ahead and list the databases here. And let's see, it's not quite working. I might have entered the wrong password here. But let me change that and then test the connection, make sure it can connect to the database correctly there. I'm going to go ahead and save this, and then we can go back and modify this to select the database we want. So we need to go to Edit Connection here, choose our connection that we just edited, and then choose our table or database right like that. So that's our inventory database. That's all set up and ready to go. You can also rename a connection if you wanted a different name in the production environment for that. You have some configuration settings, so the temp files, the time zone, so that's very important. If you're going to export PDFs, you need the time zone set up and ready to work for that. So once that is done, choose your time zone. You could do some authorization keys if you're doing Google Maps. That's another feature if you want to set that up. You can configure your APIs if those are separate for the production. So this is my email API that we set up to email PDFs. You can change your password for the production admin, and you can get some help here. That's the documentation. And then you can also log out, which we're going to do. So now we're logged out, and now we can go back to that same directory that we did before, and everything should be set up. So there we go. There is our login application. Go ahead and log in and test to make sure everything is set up and working. Go ahead and hit sign in. And you could do extensive testing on this, but for now, we're just going to wait for this to load. And as you can see, everything seems to be working. Our data is set up. Our applications are set up. So now we're in a live production environment, and this app is now live. So now you can celebrate that you've made your app live. And that's how you do a local deployment in Scriptcase.